Blackstone Audio presents Hardwired by Walter Jon Williams. Thanks and a tip of the 10-gallon hat to Terry Boren and Laura Mixon, a.k.a. the Bar Conspirators. And special thanks to Roger Zelazny, who let me play in his alley. Chapter 1. By midnight, he knows his discontent will not let him sleep. The panzerboy drives north from Santa Fe, over the Sangre de Cristos, on the high road through Truchas, heading for Colorado, wanting to get as close as possible to the night sky. He drives without the use of hands or feet, his mind living in the cool neural interface that exists somewhere between the swift images that pass before his windscreen and the electric awareness that is the alloy body and liquid crystal heart of the Maserati. His artificial eyes, plastic and steel, stare unblinking at the road, at twisting dirt ruts corrugated by the spring runoff, tall stands of pine and aspen, high meadows spotted with the frozen black shapes of cattle, all outlined in the rushing, almost liquid light of his high beams as he pushes the Maserati upward. The shapes that blaze in the headlights stand boldly against the darkness of their own shadows, and Cowboy can almost see himself in a monochrome world like a black and white celluloid image projected before his windscreen, flickering with the speed of his passage. It's almost like flying. He'd thought, when he got his new Kikuyu eyes, that he'd ask for a monochrome option, amused by the idea of flicking some mental switch in his head and being plunged into the action of some black and white fantasy, an old moving picture starring the likes of Gary Cooper or Duke Wayne. But there hadn't been much demand for monochrome, and the option had been discontinued. He'd also wanted irises of chrome steel, but the Dodger, his manager, had talked him out of that, saying they were too conspicuous for a man in Cowboy's line of business. Cowboy agreed reluctantly, as he always did when the Dodger came up with a new restriction on his fantasy. Instead, he'd taken pupils of a storm cloud gray. But here, in these mountains named after the blood of Christ, are fantasies older than any on celluloid. They pass in montage before his steel and plastic eyes. An old whitewashed church, the area around its doors painted like a turquoise heaven, clashing with the reds and yellows that form a pyramid and all-seeing eye at the rounded cap of the arch. Some massive white castle in the Moroccan style, the playhouse of a long-vanished Arab, its crumbling minarets streaked with brown, its rococo iron grillwork scored with advancing rust. Suddenly, around a curve, a pair of pale ghosts appear like figures of supernatural warning, Indian pilgrims dressed in white, from the cloth binding their foreheads and braiding their long hair to the white doe-skin moccasins that wink with silver buttons. Walking patiently by moonlight, a penance to the sanctuary at Chimayo, there to give thanks to the carved santos or ask the Virgin for a favor. Visions, like outposts of another time, preserved here on the high rim of earth, shimmering in the sudden brightness of Cowboy's eyes. Cowboy pushes the machine to the max, redlining the scales on the dashboard. Flying at night is the thing he does best. The engine whine echoes from the trees, the hills. Wind gusts through the open windows, bringing the sharp smell of pine. Cowboy pictures the celluloid speeding through the projector, moving faster, images blurring. Neurons pulse their messages to the crystal in his head, transmitting his will to the throttle, the gears, the jouncing wheels. Now the Maserati is moving downhill, gaining speed as it races through the switchbacks, finally tearing across the surface of the ford in front of Peñasco, throwing up a wall of mist that for a short moment reflects the headlights in rainbows, a hallucinatory shimmer on the edge of vision, a foreshadowing of color here in the monochrome world. It's dawn when the Maserati blurs across the Colorado line, and early morning by the time the bronze machine enters Custer County. The mountains are brown and green now, alive with pine and the mountain wind, the monochrome fantasy gone. Cowboy has friends here. He turns into a private dirt road, knowing there are electronics suddenly taking an interest in him. The road twists upward.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.